in this video we'll be showing you how to paint your Slaves to Darkness Chaos Warriors. We'll be painting quickly and efficiently to get your models looking great and on the tabletop in no time at all. The first thing we've done is undercoat our model, and for this colour scheme we've used Lead Belcher. This will give us a bit of a head start with the armour, saving us lots of time. The paints you'll need are on the screen right now. Remember that these are our recommendations. Feel free to paint your miniatures however you like. If you are new to painting or want to know the paints and techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. First, we're going to apply rattling grime all over the undercoated armour. We're going to add a little drop of water to it so it's not too dark, as we want some of that metal showing through. You can make it a little darker though in some areas if you want to. We're going to apply it in small amounts at a time and keep it moving it around so we don't add too much in some of the recesses. If it does pool too heavily, don't worry, you can always take a clean brush and soak it away while it's still wet. Next, we're going to dry brush some iron breaker really lightly to catch those edges. We just want to make subtle layers as we don't want the highlight to be too strong, but you can make it as strong or as subtle as you like. We're using our small dry brush for this as it's the right size to be fairly precise and get into those trickier to reach areas without being too heavy on the rest of the armour. Dry brushing is a super quick way to get the armour highlighted. It doesn't matter if we make a mess on the other areas of the model as we'll be painting over them very soon. You can learn more about dry brushing by watching our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos. Next, we'll be using Steel Legion Drab for the inside of the cloak and the fur details. We are using a medium layer brush for this to get nice neat brush strokes, so when it's dry it's super smooth, but it also gets enough into those hard to reach places. You can also use this for the boots if you want an alternative colour for them for the rest of your warriors. Now we're moving on to Catechan flesh. This can be used for any leathers such as straps, boots and gloves, but you can also use this colour for a darker fur colour on any of your warriors. We want to make sure that we get a couple of coats of this to make sure that we have a solid coverage. After that, we're applying Retributor Armour with our medium layer brush to get into all those small details and avoid smudging into the painted armour and straps. We'll need a few coats of this so we get a good solid gold colour before we move on. We'll need multiple coats of this colour to build it up over any other colours before it. Now is the best time to change our paint water to avoid mixing metallic flakes into our next colours. Next, we're using corn red on the outside of the cloak. We can also use this on any loincloths, or you can pop a little bit in the helmet visor for some simple red glowing eyes. We need to apply a couple of layers of this to build over the silver undercoat of the warrior. Corn red is a great paint as it's such a rich colour but also very dark like the Chaos Gods. Now we're going to use Agrax Earthshade over the Retributor Armour, Catechan Flesh and Steel Legion Drab. If you find the shade too dark in some areas, you can always thin it down with a drop of water and apply it. We are working in small sections and moving it around the desired areas. This helps stop shade drying too quickly and heavily in one area. If it is, don't worry, you can always grab a clean brush and soak up the shade if there is too much starting to pool. Finally, we're applying Druky Violet over the corn red details. We want it in the recesses, so try and keep it thin on the raised areas. Don't worry, we can always tidy up those raised areas with corn red if it's too dark. Just like our other shades, if it's pooling too heavily in recesses, always take a clean brush and soak it up. If you want the cloth recesses darker, you can always add another layer after the first one is dry. And there we are, your Chaos Warrior is finished and looking awesome. You can see that our model is based in Astrogranite, but you can base it in any colour you want. If you'd like to know more about basing, check out our technical paints video all about it. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!